when I'm in your van, now that you've described this feeling that you have of wanting to travel and with your ministry, my respect for your van and what you've created here has been up-leveled,
right?
Because this is beautiful, and it really reflects the calling and the spirit that's in you.
Thank you.
Hi everybody, I'm here today to show you guys Treasure. I hope you enjoy my van tour. First off, Treasure is a Ford E350 and she has 300,000 miles on her.
Woo,
cha, she old. And anyway, you guys, I got Treasure for $1,300, you guys. And I built her out in the back of a parking lot of a grocery store. And so, we're going to show you the outside of Treasure.
Did you build this yourself? Did other people join in?
My van build is a complete build that I did myself. A lot of the things I had in home life, and I was trying to figure out what I could do. So this is actually a bookshelf that I had in home life that I turned it over to the side, and I didn't have to build anything on here. But I did cut a hole in it to be able to do this on both sides.
So is this, it's on its side.
Yeah.
And then the shelves are the natural partitions.
Yeah. So I did not add these shelves in here. It just worked out that way and everything fits perfectly. So I took a bookshelf from Home Life, and I had to cut it because it was actually longer than this. So I had to cut it down on the sides, and then I had to cut holes in it to be able to do it that way.
How did you do it under such a stressful situation, which we'll talk about in your interview, which is a separate video. But maybe you could just touch on that a little bit here.
Well, if you guys do not know, I was homeless for a number of years. I lived in a building for a very long time with no lights, no gas, and no water. Homelessness prepared me for van life because I had to try to figure out how to navigate not having lights, not having water, not having gas. And so I actually started canning while I was homeless because I didn't have a refrigerator. Even though I had a vacant building that I was staying in, I did not have a refrigerator because I didn't have lights or anything. And so I would go to the food pantry and I would get meat, but I didn't have a way to keep it. And so I started researching on YouTube about canning, and I started canning while I was homeless, and I actually didn't know that you could can meat, and I found out that you can meat, and I was like, this is a game changer. I can be homeless and still eat. And so I started canning my foods, and whenever I would get money, a lot of people, I think it was a church, found out. I'm going to start crying. It was a church found out that I was living in the building. And I think they informed everybody in the church that I was living in this building. And everybody just started. I started getting phone calls out of nowhere with people giving me stuff, donating stuff to me, giving me stuff. And when I would go there, they would give me gift cards to Subway. Some of them would give me money. Some of them would give me gas money to come and get the stuff. Some stuff they would give me was brand new. I started selling the stuff just to have something to eat. This lady, I think she was the first one who came across me, and she was like, Vanessa, don't worry. The lady and her husband brought a whole trailer full of stuff that she was getting rid of. She was having a garage sale. She couldn't sell it. She was tired of trying to sell it, and she and her husband took two truckloads of a trailer and brought it to the building that I was staying in and say, Vanessa, have a garage sale and sell everything. And after that, people started calling me out of the woodworks. I couldn't even sell because I had to go get the stuff. And they start calling me out the woodwork. And so I was able, like if they gave me something that I could use, I would use it. And I was able to get the things I needed. I was able to buy my canning jars. I was able to buy just the propane tanks, the gas, or whatever I needed. I had a little antique stove, propane stove that I would actually cook on. So even though I was living in this building with no lights, no gas, and no water, just like I fixed up my van, I fixed up the inside of that building to where you would walk in and you would think it was a mansion and you would think that it had lights on in the inside, but it did not. And so I had propane lanterns and everything. And that's how I survived. But that also prepared me. I was destined to do van life because it prepared me and gave and taught me about the propane tank. It taught me about survival. It taught me about the black tank for the water because I didn't have water. So I had a container that I would catch water in, and that's how I would take a bath. I would catch the rainwater from outside. I fixed the gutters on the outside of the building where they would drain down and the water would come into the thing. So I would catch the rainwater and I would bathe. I would wash dishes. I would do everything that I needed to do. And so this life is not a hard life for me. And a lot of people also ask me, was homelessness hard? That wasn't hard for me either because I have more stories to tell and maybe we'll get to them one day. But my whole life has prepared me for, I wouldn't say a hard life, but I would say a life of survival and a life of ingenuity and a life of figuring out things and not letting obstacles stand in your way. I talk a lot, you guys. So let's get through this van tour. Right here are some black crates that everybody have. But of course, I have to be fancy because I'm Vanessa. But anyway, you guys, so I just take a regular crate and I cover it up with a t-shirt. This is just a regular t-shirt. I didn't cut it or anything.
How do you get the t-shirt to fit around the entire crate?
So nobody asked that. So it's just a t-shirt.
Oh, it's a tank top and it fits right. Look at that. Okay, let's make sure that comes across. That is cool.
So this was just a regular t-shirt.
And that keeps it all nice and pretty.
And I can get it in any color I want.
Who would have thought a way to color coordinate your milk crates?
And I had a yellow one up there at one time, so when I wanted the yellow, when I switch it out. So when I go to the thrift store and I see something for 25 cents and it matches my decor, I can change my decor anytime I want to. And it's so simple and easy when you just have cloth and t-shirts that are you're decorating. And I didn't cut it or anything. I just take it and put it over. Well, now that I dry my tears. Okay, you guys, up at the top, I have a storage container. Mm-hmm. And that's usually I switch out summer and winter clothes, summer and winter items. So right now we're in the colder weather. So all my summer clothes are up there. And I also have a water tank on top. This is an 18-gallon tank that I actually personalized and made it into what I needed it to be. I actually cut a hole in the top, and if you want to see how I did that, I have the whole DIY on my YouTube channel.
Oh, excellent. And what is your YouTube channel again?
It's Vanessa's Van Life Journey.
Okay, great. It's gravity-fed, and you put a hole through, and you have a DIY. Mm-hmm. Excellent.
And so in the back, I have a hose back here that I don't take showers in my van. A lot of people ask. So I'm going to touch on the questions that everybody be asking and they want to know, where does she take a shower at? I do not take a shower in my van. I have a gym membership. to Planet Fitness. And usually when I'm in a city where there is a gym membership, I take a shower there. But also I have a method of taking a bath in my van where I take a very, very, very good bath. Oh. And I also have that on my channel if you want to know how I take a bath in my van. But the gravity fed water, if I wanted to take a shower back here, I could, but I don't want to and I don't have to. So, but if I want to wash dishes back here, I can wash dishes back here. If I need water for anything, I can have access to water back here. In the summertime, when it gets hot outside, this water actually comes out hot and I do not have to warm it up. Mm. So that is the bonus to having the black tank.
That would make washing your dishes easier, I would think.
Yes. And this is my little collapsible dinner tray table that I have here.
And this is looks like a plastic tray.
Yeah, this is just the regular tray that has the legs, and I took the legs off of it.
Oh, you modified it.
Yes, so I took the legs off and I'm just using this, but I can still use it with the legs on if I decide to take it out. And so I didn't have to build anything. A friend of mine gave me this and I just do that.
And you held it on with these U-brackets.
With the U-brackets. And so underneath here, I have a lot of storage that I can just take this off.
Ooh.
And I have an extra propane tank. And in the back, I have my air compressor. This is my gray water tank. Mm-hmm. And just a lot of storage, my extra batteries for my drills and saws. And to put this back on, all I do is stick that in.
What is that? What is it? What kind of material is this?
This is the shower material from Home Depot that you normally put in your shower. And I just cut it down and painted it.
This is repurposing taken to the next level.
Yes. And I just painted it my colors. And yeah. I just put that in there like that.
What are your colors, Vanessa?
My colors are black and white. I do not have a favorite color. A lot of people think because of the accent of yellow that my favorite color is yellow, but it is not. I do not have a favorite color. My favorite, I do not have a favorite color, but if someone makes me pick, I will pick black and white. And if they make me pick from black and white, then I'll pick black. And yellow just happened. I needed an accent color. So yellow just happened to make its way in.
Yellow really makes black pop.
Yeah, so that's it. And then on the side door over here, I have some baskets.
Ooh, now, okay, these are just standard storage baskets. You screwed
yes,
in.
And they came in with the, they came in with the screws. I can actually take them off.
Ooh.
Or I can put them back on. And I just utilize them on my door because when I'm in the inside, and I close my door, which I'll show you guys and demonstrate to you. When I close my door, I have everything right there where I could just grab and have access to. And you guys are probably wondering where the blue comes in. My baby sister died of stage 4 cancer in 2018, and her favorite color was blue. So that is, you will see just hints of blue in my van, and that's a representation of my deceased sister. Mm. So if you guys want to come inside the van, I'm going to go have a seat and please join me.
Knock, knock.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi, and welcome to my humble abode.
This is
treasure.
It is a treasure. And that's the name of your van?
Yes, that's her name.
Oh, she is beautiful. Let's just take Thank a look you. Around here. Well, look at that. I wonder what the V stands for.
Vanessa's Van Life Journey.
Ah.
And this pillow got messed up in the laundry. So I have to get another V.
Oh, I see. A little something there.
Yeah, it got messed up.
How pretty. How pretty. Okay. So tell us all about your magical space.
Okay, you guys. So in van life, I had to decide what was most important to me. And I suggest you guys do that. Decide what's most important to you. And what was most important to me was having a stove to cook on. And with that responsibility comes needing a refrigerator. So I have a four burner stove over in the back with my blue tea kettle to remind me of my sister. And I cook, I food prep, I can my foods all on that stove. And
you, if I may say, you cook large servings.
Yes.
And you will cook multiple items at a time.
Yes, I cook like four different meals at a time to food prep so I can alternate. And so I just food prepped the other day down here in Quartzsite, Arizona. I hosted a food prepping class to teach people how to food prep and eat healthy on the road. So if you have an event and you would like me to show up.
Yeah, staying healthy on the road is a challenge.
Yes, it is. And I like to eat home-cooked food. I don't like fast food, and I like to eat healthy. I'm currently on the carnivore diet. I've been doing that diet for 8 months, and I'm kind of trying ketovore right now.
Ketovore.
So it's a little bit of, I've added spinach, and I've added Brussels sprouts, and avocado, and onions, and sweet peppers into the diet, but I mainly eat mostly meat.
Okay, so, oh my goodness. How many days worth of cooking do you have in there? How long before you have to cook again?
Usually, because I haven't cooked my liver and onions yet, but I also have some up here in the freezer. Right now, I have probably about 2 weeks of food up in here. And when I cook my liver and onions, that's actually four meals because it's two meals per pack. So that's actually four meals right there when I cook my liver and onions. So I try to eat liver and onions once or twice a week.
And how many hours do you cook in order to have
2 weeks I usually of take 2 days of cooking. So one day I'll cook as much as I can, and then the next day I'll just continue. But if I start early enough, then I can get through with everything.
So whoever says, you know, van life has to be, you know, not only living in a can, but eating out of a tin can, they got some learning to do from you.
And that's another thing. A lot of people say, well, I bet her van smells because she cooks in it. And they're like, well, what about the odors of the van? And I can't comprehend that. People come in my van all the time. I've done several van tours, and everybody always asks me, why does your van smell so good? What are you doing to make your van smell good? I'm always cleaning, and I have my doors open, and I'm airing out my van, so I don't have an issue with odors.
And you have the vent fan.
Yes, and if anybody
you have the vent.
Smells my van, they can tell me so I can start cleaning immediately.
I mean, it smells just great in here. It smells totally normal in here.
And to me, my van smells like food, if it does smell like food, I'm fine with that because I love the smell of foods that I cook. So, okay, you guys. So I want to show you guys my prized possession, which was the second thing that I needed in van life. And that was, I needed a lot of storage. I want to change clothes every day or however often that I want to change clothes. I don't want to wear the same outfit all the time. So I have a floor to ceiling closet that is the length of the van. It goes all the way to the back here. A lot of people are stunned and surprised at this and amazed. And I slide this all the way. And then if I bend down on it just a little,
I can take magic trick.
Oh my. So I'm born on Christmas Day, and for Christmas, I usually do not splurge throughout the year. Everything else I spend on my van, and I've gotten it to the point where I'm comfortable now. But for my birthday, I usually treat myself, and my subscribers also allow me to treat myself because I have an Amazon wish list. So I just put things on my Amazon wish list that I would love. And this year, my subscribers and companies reached out to me, and they showed out, you guys. Like, I had over 100 gifts that I unboxed on my channel. And so I went shopping. I went shopping for my birthday, y'all. So I got some clothes, y'all. Y'all, look at this. I got, girl, wait till y'all see me wear this. I don't know if I'm gonna wear this yet, but I got a cute little short set with the girl. I got clothes. Now, I don't know if y'all got clothes in y'all closet, but y'all didn't expect me to have this in van life, did you? Sorry. Sorry. I'm not disappointing, child.
You got to wear that at the campfire.
Child, I don't know where I'm wearing this at, but I'm wearing it somewhere. So, you know, I went shopping for my birthday, and I have options. I have clothes, and I love that. And that's what I wanted. I'm kind of into two pieces now, because the two pieces are giving me the options to mix and match. It's giving me the options to just have more with little. I think you can get more out of two pieces because you can mix and match everything. So, yes, thanks to all my subscribers. I'm giving you guys a shout out, wink, wink, for everything that you bought for me for my birthday. I appreciate you guys. But it's because of my subscribers that everything that you see here in my van, I was able to do. My subscribers, they were so enthused with me building on my van. They were there with me the whole step of the way. Anything that I needed for my van, from my solar panels to the plumbing or whatever, I was receiving cash apps. I was getting things bought for me and sent to me off my Amazon wish list. So in my van didn't happen overnight, but my van didn't also just happen because of my hard work. My van happened because of the contributions and the love and the support for my subscribers. And I will never, ever forget them. And I will always give them a shout out whenever I do a van tour, because if it wasn't for my subscribers, what you see here today would not even exist. So I just want to let y'all know that. Y'all, thank my subscribers.
Yay, subscribers.
And so when I get ready to put it back in, all I have to do is that. And it's very simple and it's very easy. And voila. And it's the same thing over here.
Is this more clothes over here or more other kinds of storage?
This is where I typically try to limit myself to clothing, because I have to limit myself, because if I don't, I'll go overboard. So I pretty much...
You know, Vanessa, that's why Goddess invented trailers.
No, we don't. We want to go places that trailers can't go. So I try to limit myself to just my clothing in this area. And here I have everything that I need to take a bath with. So when I get ready to take my bath, it's all in this little container right here. Okay. And yeah, I like everything to be organized. So this right here, I could just pull this out. And this is like all my personal hygiene items. And the other stuff is just extra stuff that I might need. And I just push that back in there. I don't believe in paper plates and paper cups. Okay. So all of my home life dishes are right here in here. Mm. And I have all my plates, my bowls, and just everything that I need is in here.
When you're driving, do you hear a lot of clanking? Is anything ever chipped or broken with the system?
No.
All right.
And I have mason jars, so nothing is...
Yeah, for all your canning, right? All those mason jars.
And right here.
Yeah.
So I have mason jars everywhere throughout my van. I have a lot of people saying, too, how do you keep the rodents away? Mm-hmm. And I think you using mason jars. Rats can eat through plastic. Mm-hmm. Rats can eat through paper. But I've never met one that could eat through glass. So...
I hope we never do.
So there you have it. So I use glass to store all my things in. And because I'm on the carnivore diet, I really don't have to worry about having things that attract rats, because I have no flour. Mm. I have no sugar. Oh. I have no cornmeal. I don't have all that stuff that most people are having. I don't drink coffee. So I don't have that stuff that people have to attract rats. I have meat. And it's usually in glass jars, canned, or it's usually in my refrigerator. So I don't have that issue.
I never thought about that. Yeah, so all the grain is what's attracting the rodents and the sugar.
Probably so.
You can can. Do you have a DIY for canning your meat?
Yes, I've done canning videos on my channel. So if y'all want to see that, and I'm also willing to host a canning class if anybody wants me to demonstrate how I can. So, but I do have videos on the everything that I'm talking about. These were DIYs that I actually did on my channel. So there are videos to every single thing that you want to see, to building this cabinet out, to everything that I built in the van. It's all on my channel, you guys. A plethora of information to help you guys navigate through whatever it is you're trying to do.
Great. That's wonderful. And I've heard great things about your channel.
Thank you.
Now, you also have this counter here, and it's a fixed counter.
Mm-hmm.
And I see it has a lip here, so you can get your knees under there.
Yes.
And what do you use this counter for?
Well, typically, I use this as my personal hygiene. Mm-hmm. This is a flower pot that I've bought from Walmart. And so I usually do my personal hygiene in here, brush my teeth, wash my face. I used to take a bath in this one as well, but I have a better method now of taking a bath. And so I've demonstrated that as well on my channel. So this is aesthetically pleasing.
It sure is. It's
and
beautiful.
It's just for brushing my teeth, washing my face. And if I ever have water that I want to put into the gray tank or whatever, I could just pour it down here. But I only use this for my personal hygiene. So I don't pour dishwater or anything else down up in here, because I don't want that smell in my gray tank. So I only use this for like brushing my teeth and washing my face or my bath water. But usually, typically, I can just take the bath water and just throw it outside, so I don't have to be emptying my gray tank all the time. So when I get ready to fill my tea kettle up or anything, or I need water, I just do it from here. So,
and you filter your water to drink?
No, I actually buy my water. Oh. I buy my own drinking water, bottled water. So I just use this to bathe with and to wash dishes with. And that's 18 gallons. It usually lasts me about 2 weeks.
That's a long time. Yeah. You have 2 weeks of food and 2 weeks of water.
Yeah, so usually I'll be running out of both at the same time.
So you can go to the LVAs and stay put.
I can go wherever I want to go and just stay put. And all I have to do is pull my ladder out. I usually go to car washes and fill up my water at the car wash on the rinse cycle.
You just blew my mind.
So that's what I usually do. That's how I get my water. When people say, where are you going to get water from? I'm trying to answer all the questions that you guys are going to have in the comments. Because some things just don't, you know, some things people just don't, they don't live this lifestyle, so they don't understand.
There are so many ways to accomplish the same thing.
Yeah, so
we
I go
get our water in different ways, and that is that's brilliant.
I go
that.
To because
I'm gonna have to try that.
Because I'm using it just to cook with and bathe with, I just go to the car wash and I get my ladder down and I stand up on top of the ladder and take that little thing and fill it up. So, you guys, I know this is a lot to digest at one time, but the show must go on, okay? So, anyway, you guys, I am going to show you guys the back of my van and how I get to the under storage back there. And everything in my van serves multiple purposes. Oh, by the way, you guys, these little boxes right here, these are covered with a skirt that I got from the thrift store. They don't come like that. That's not made like that, you guys. Don't ask me where I got them from, because you can't go buy them like that. But you can go get the little cubicles. That's the little cubicles from Walmart or any place with the little, you know, the cubicles. I use those for storage for my shoes. So all of my shoes are in the inside of there. So those have multiple purposes. It's seating and it is also storage. So when I want to move around and cook and get to my stove, all I do, I typically don't have this rug out. This rug is just for show, just for tours, just to be extra.
Like red carpet.
It's just to be extra. But typically I just move these around to wherever I want. And typically when I want to sit in front of my vanity over here, my sink, I just move that over there. And then this other one, when I want to cook, you guys, even though I have a bench over here, which I don't know if you guys seen the fixed bench, but I'm getting ready to tear this out soon, and I'm going to make me a, I don't know the name of it, because it's going to be my invention, but I'm going to make like a, what's the name of it going to be, girl? Come up with it right now. I don't know. It's going to be like a, I want to say armoire, but not. Ooh. It's going to be like the china cabinets that people, but ooh, it's going to house all my pots and pans.
Oh, nice.
And dishes. The dishes that you see here, yeah, are not going to be there anymore. So I'm going to build something here because I'm not using this seat anymore.
Oh.
The way I wanted, had intended, because I intended to use the seat to cook. But when I turn on that seat to cook, it hurts my side because I'm not able to lean all the way back because of this slant.
Oh, yes.
So I'm going to build something here that is going to be decorative.
A treasure chest.
And but it's going to come all the way up, and I'm going to have my pots and my pans in it.
Will it have a glass front?
If I, you're going to have to stay tuned for all that. So when I cook, you guys, I take this bench. And I, this is how I cook. I just cook in the front of here, and I can get whatever I need at my refrigerator and my trash can moves down here. And so I can throw whatever I need to throw in the trash can.
What a great system.
And also this one right here comes over here. And I have a cutting board that I put on top of here, and I actually turn this way now.
Oh, so like an L-shaped kitchen.
Yeah, I could turn this way now, and I can chop and cut all my onions and bell peppers up.
Do you ever swivel all the way around and use this counter as well?
While I'm cooking, no. Ooh. What I really wanted to show you guys is the understorage that I showed you in the back. I have access to all of that storage from the inside.
Wow.
Those are all my pots and pans that go all the way through to the back.
Wow.
These are all my canned foods and meats.
Wow, you are ready for anything. You really could cater.
Yeah, girl, stop trying to give me another job.
just a subtle hint.
And so, like we were saying earlier, you guys, I don't know if I mentioned this. But I dumpster dive a lot, and I dumpster dove for things in my van. And so, this little door right here was a piece of wood that I found in the dumpster, from a store that threw it away. And I already had the countertop in Home Life, so I put the countertop on there. I already had this countertop in, you know, so I put the countertop on there. So this is things that I actually jumped in the dumpster for. And so not everything in my van is purchased. It's a lot of it is just, it's just a compilation of different things that I've gotten. And Rome was not built in a day, you guys. So if you don't have everything that you need for your van right now, just work on one project at a time. And as you work on that project, you're going to eventually get everything that you need. So, yeah, I got that from dumpster diving. The molding on the side here, I got that out of the dumpster from dumpster diving. And the molding up at the top, I found on clearance at Home Depot on their wood pile in the back that's on clearance. I think I paid like $5 or something for the whole piece of wood. So
does the piece of wood go back? Oh,
I
see it.
It goes all the way.
Oh, that's really nice.
Yeah, so I think I got that for like $5 or something.
And you can attach all kinds of things to it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's nice. And I know you've had support from your subscribers and others. And is that what the ceiling...
Yes, my subscribers send me cards. A lot of my subscribers support my channel through Cash App or PayPal. But a lot of people do not have Cash App or PayPal, and they want to support me as well. And so most of the cards that you see on my ceiling had cash money in it. They just send me the cash in the cards. Oh. And that way I don't have to go to the bank and try to cash a check or whatever. Mm. So they, a lot of them had one particular subscriber that I'm going to give a shout out to, because the majority of the cards on the ceiling are from her. She sent me like $100 every month. So most of the cards on the ceiling are from one of my subscribers, and her name is Miss Mary! Miss Mary, but she's not the only one. All the cards are not from her, but a lot of them are from Miss Mary. So you guys, I have so much living space in my van, and I wanted to initially build my van like all the other vans that I seen on YouTube, but God just was not letting that happen, baby. And so back here where the stove and the refrigerator is, that was going to be the bed, but I did not sleep comfortably on that, and I kept falling down, and my covers ended up on the floor, and I was like, ain't no way this is gonna be my bed. And so y'all, I came up with the floor plan, and then it was just like a no-brainer for me. Now some people this might not work for, but it was a no-brainer for me. And it was like, you know, you build a platform, which is plywood, to sleep on, and then you have this fixed bed that everybody sees when they walks into the van, and everybody is sitting on your van because you also use it as seating space. I don't want nobody's butt on my bed or my pillows. I just don't.
So what did you do?
So right here in the middle aisle is my floor, and that is my bed. Like, I put my mattress is behind that curtain right there up front, which I'll show you guys. My mattress is behind this curtain.
Another magic curtain?
Another magic curtain. Not a magic carpet, but a magic curtain.
What kind of mattress is it?
It's just some mattress that one of my subscribers bought for me off of Amazon, and it costs like $140 or $50. And it's just a regular twin size mattress. And if you guys would like, I'll do it just for you.
Wow.
Wow. Because y'all are pain in the butt with all them questions in the comments. Where is your bed?
We're finally going to get that settled right here and now.
And so, at night, when I get ready to go to bed, I just pull this out. This is a exercise mat that I put on the floor first. I'm not going to put that out today, but I put that on the floor first. And that keeps down the moisture and the condensation that a mattress would have in the wintertime.
Oh, right. Gives you a barrier.
So I just take my mattress, you guys, and I put it on the floor.
Oh, that perfect fit.
And it is a perfect fit.
Did you measure ahead of time, and that's why you built
no.
this cover?
No. Everything is by design. The master did it. So the space came first and the mattress came later. So, and then I just take my pillow that I've been sitting my butt on all day long, and then I just put my blanket here, and I just happily, oh, comfortably,
oh my goodness,
go to sleep at night, and I get such good night's sleep.
Your little cocoon.
Yes. And like, it's just, I don't know, it's just, it's enough room here. People are like, that's not, it's enough room for another person if I wanted a person. By the way, I'm celibate. Don't contact me. Thank you very much. But I'm celibate, single, and happy, but I just sleep here and I love it. Like,
well, it fits you perfectly. And it really is the same width as a twin bed or a small bed.
Yeah, it's not depriving at all. This is where I sleep every night, and it's long enough. It's I can toss, I can turn, I can stretch, I even exercise here, by the way.
Right.
So anyway, I have enough room, and some people was like, I'll get on that floor and I'll never get up. But you can, because this right here is pull up for you guys who need it. Now, I don't need it, but it's pull up for you guys who need it. And I just don't know why I need to have a bed. I don't know.
You're doing it your own way. We all find our own way.
But if you need a bed, get you a fixed bed, and you're probably not going to have a four burner stove and a refrigerator, but you know, it's totally up to you. But this is my space. And you know, I've seen some more comments on other channels about my van, and my van is designed the way I wanted it to be designed. So you really don't have to give me suggestions. It's already a done deal. You don't have to give me, well, you should have did it that way. You should have did it that way. And it's really cluttered. It's really not. It's really what I wanted and needed in van life. And so it's catered to me. So everybody else wants to know, where do I use the bathroom at, you guys? And I've come up with the method that everybody needs to use. Trial and error, of course, but I came up with it. Everything in my van serves multiple purposes. A lot of people are always staring at my mattress and saying, where do you sleep? They don't know that is the mattress. And then a lot of people are always staring at my toilet and they don't know it. But again, I have a skirt that I got. This is a regular lady skirt from the thrift store that was my colors and my pattern. I was like, oh, that's so cute. That'll fit over my toilet. And it did. And so you're staring at my toilet. And this is my blanket that I use at night to put on my bed. And so in the morning when I fix my bed, all I have to do, and I fix my bed by putting it up, and all I have to do is pick it up, and then I take my blanket and I squeeze it down up in there. And that is a form of decoration, and it's housing my blanket. So
I have a question for you.
Sure.
Is that your only blanket?
No, I have in the wintertime, I have, now, fun fact, I cannot sleep without cover on me. So in the summer, I have to still sleep with this blanket. So this is my winter and summer blanket. But in the wintertime, I have to pull out two other blankets. So I have another blanket that's sort of like this, but it's all black. And my subscribers sent me this. I sleep with two of these in the wintertime, and it's actually enough. And then if not, then I have a little third blanket. But the winter has gotten down in Pahrump. I was in Pahrump before I came down here, and it got down to 27 degrees. And actually, I was coming from under these blankets because it was a little too warm.
And you were sleeping on the floor.
And I'm sleeping
on
the floor.
Is your floor insulated?
It's insulated a little bit. I think, I can't remember, but it does get cold on my floor, but I don't understand why once I have the mat down there, mm-hmm. and once I have my mattress down there, and once I have my blankets on, I do not feel anything, and I do not sleep with heat on in the van.
And you also have that rubber exercise mat, which is insulating you. But may I ask, what kind of insulation is in the ceiling and the walls?
I have foam insulation in the ceiling, and I have regular home insulation, the pink insulation in my walls.
Okay.
And so...
yeah, so you've got that going.
It still gets pretty cool in here, and the floor is the coldest thing in here, but I sleep in my van in the wintertime, and I do not feel, once I get under, and a key is I have on warm pajamas, and I have on thick socks, so my subscribers have hooked me up with a bunch of thick socks in the wintertime, and then I have two of these blankets and another blanket if I need it. And I stay warm. So I'm showing y'all everything today. Y'all is getting an exclusive interview. Girl, I'm going to sit on this toilet and I'm going to show you how I do my do. Ain't nobody never showed you this before. This is my toilet. I lift off the top. I'm going to show you that later, lady. Move out the way.
I'm excited about that toilet.
But I sit on my toilet right here. I do number one and I do number two. Yes, I do. You asked and I told you. So anyway, you guys, this is my toilet. It's beautiful. It's decorative. Nobody would ever know. I have two bags that I have found to be very fail safe. These are the regular bags that you get at Walmart. And I double them, put two in there, and I use pine pellets. So I take a mason jar of pine pellets. I have some in there already. And I just pour it in the bag.
I keep
my extra bags up in here.
Oh, I'm going to get a shot of those pellets. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's like basically half of the igloo.
Yeah, so I kind of do a little half, and then I put the bag down on top. And this is a revision of my toilet since anybody else has done a tour of it. Because at first, I used to just sit on the lip of this is a regular water cooler. So in van life, sometimes I would sit on this thing and I would have my phone in my hand and I'm sitting on this thing. And when I get up, I have a ring around my butt. The toilet bag is sealed and infused into my butt. When I get up, the toilet bag is getting up and everything, you guys. So I was like, where is the toilet seat? And so the regular toilet seat that you buy does not fit on the Gatorade thing. So what I did, it only fits on a regular bucket. So what I did was, you guys are seeing this here first, it's exclusive. What I did was I got a regular bucket and I cut it and I put it around my cooler.
Oh, now why did you have to cut that out on the side there?
Because you need it to go all the way down. You need the arms to slide down.
Oh, man. Okay. So may I come
this
in
is
here
sliding.
I see. You cut the top third or so of the 5-gallon bucket so that it could slide over your igloo as to make it a wider seating area in order
so this can fit on here. And now I can, let me put this back.
And that is such a sturdy bucket.
This is sturdier than a regular bucket. Mm-hmm. And that's why I prefer this. Because I could have just went with the regular bucket. But also, this is not only sturdier, but it's because you have the lid that can screw on here. So if you need, when you're traveling and you don't want anything to fall out, then you can screw your lid on here.
Yeah, on the 5-gallon one.
Yeah, and that keeps the odors. It helps, even though the pine pellets are going to eliminate your odor from number one and number two. If you want that extra security of eliminating odor, then you just screw the top on. And this top does go on while this is on here. I'm just not using it that way now. But when I get ready to travel, I just put that top back on there.
And which top? Is it the top for the 5-gallon or the top for the igloo?
The top for the igloo.
The igloo.
It screws on.
Oh, okay.
And it can screw on while the plastic bag is on there as well. You don't have to take that off. And so now I can have a toilet seat just by doing this.
That's a great system now. And is it also the case that smaller bags will now fit more easily?
And see, that is another reason why I did not want to go with the bucket, because my bags that I am used to using does not fit around the bucket. And so I would have had to get bigger bags, which would have cost more money. And so these bags right here are perfect for this, but it wouldn't have been perfect for the regular bucket. So I wanted to, you know, these bags went up after the virus came. The bags went up and they are a little bit more expensive than they were before. So I don't want to pay more. And then you don't need a bigger bag than this.
Right.
But you would have to upgrade to a bigger bag to be able to fit over the 5-gallon bucket. So this works for me. And it's all about being innovative and creative. I always think outside the box. When I see a problem, I don't look at it as an obstacle, like a problem without a solution. I look at it as a problem that I'm going to figure out the solution to. So that is my toilet. I'm going to show you guys my lounge area up in the front of my van. Now, when I told you guys that I dumpster dive, all of this wood that you have right here for this thing right here, I jumped into a dumpster to get it. They had a lot of good wood. I wish that I would have found this dumpster. They would have had this dumpster when I built this thing, because I wouldn't have to have spent so much money. But I got all this wood for free, and this was very, very, very good wood. And I just painted it my design, and I have a cushion on top. And this can seat two people up here, and then somebody could sit in the driver's seat. So that's three people. And the two things over there, two people could sit over there. I could sit in the corner, so I can seat six people in this van comfortably, even more than that, because one person can actually sit on the toilet right here. So, and they would all be comfortable in the van.
Is there storage in here as well?
All of my battery banks, my inverter, my batteries, everything to my solar is in here. And sometimes I can put my other pillows up here at the top. And that provides cushion behind my head.
Nice. Yeah.
If I just want to lay back and just pretend like I'm going to take a break, which I never do. If you guys are a solo traveler, I highly recommend you take that passenger seat out. You're never going to use it. It's making my head itch just thinking about it. Having that passenger seat in the van. You could have all that storage underneath here, and it's just, it just looks, doesn't it look so good?
It looks wonderful.
Like, it's just,
it's cozy and homey.
Yes.
It feels almost like a studio apartment.
Taking that seat out of here is just, and having, okay, you guys, I'm just going to have to stop and give myself a pat on the back, because taking the seat out, having this storage, having that closet, having the stove, putting the bed on the floor, I'm just a genius. And I agree with all you guys in the comments. Thank you. I'm just kidding, you guys. But anyway, my name is Vanessa with Vanessa's Van Life Journey. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you like my sense of humor, I have more of that on my channel. So please subscribe to Vanessa's Van Life Journey on YouTube and also Instagram. And hopefully by the time this video comes out, I will go over to Facebook and open up an account, because I'm just lazy.
No, you're not.
But I need to do that.
Anybody looking at this van would not think you were lazy.
I just don't have time, you guys. But I need to open up a Facebook account. So maybe by the time this video comes out, I will have a Facebook account. But as of now, I do not have a Facebook account. I am on Instagram under Vanessa's Van Life Journey. And I'm also under Instagram under Vanessa's Van Life Journey VIPB. So I have two Instagram accounts on Instagram. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please subscribe to the channel that you're watching the video on, and make sure you subscribe to my channel as well. And I will see you guys later, and stick around for the interview. I think you're going to see the interview first, or I don't know, but we're going to have an interview on the channel as well. If you want to know more about me and my journey and how I started van life, I want to encourage and inspire you guys to do whatever it is that you want to do in life. Okay, bye now.
What a treat. This has been a blast. Thank you so much for this tour, and not only of your van, but also of your bright light and your strong spirit.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
I appreciate you.
Oh.
I appreciate her doing this interview with me, you guys. Like, we talked a couple of days ago, and we stayed on the phone for hours, and she laughed at all my jokes.
Well, you know, here at the Blue Wonder Lady channel, of fun and heart and learning and growth and inspiration are all a part of it. And you really do embody that, Vanessa.
Because
why?
Every woman.
Oh!
I was waiting on you to say it.
Okay, do it again.
Because
we're every woman.
She changed the words, y'all. That's not how it goes. But I'm every woman. It's all in me. Anything you want done, baby, I do it naturally. That's what I do over here. I do everything naturally, you guys. Just let it flow. Be yourself and let it flow and just do it naturally. However it comes out, it's no muss, it's no fuss. Just let it flow and do it naturally.
And remember, with those words of wisdom, you can do it. Enjoy your journey.
Bye now.
It's a wrap.
To hear Vanessa's courageous story, click the link below to watch the full heart-to-heart in-depth interview.